Okay, so here we are again with some of this BRT clay. Now, when you need to roll out clay, sometimes you don't always have the necessary tools, right? Like a rolling pin may not be handy. But what you can do is obviously slice off the amount of clay that you need, especially when you're building slabs. And now you've got your clay piece here. Just flatten a little bit, squish it flat in your hands to start with, okay? And then you can actually like throw it across the table, or table, across your board, across your table, to flatten it even further. This will stretch it out. So you can see I'm throwing it like that. So it's sort of, when it's hitting the table, it's actually sort of doing that motion. And then you can change sides and do the other width as well. And you've got a stretched piece of clay. Okay, now it's a bit thin, it's thinner on the edges here than it is in the middle. But you can, of course, work with that, cut that bit off, and work with whatever you need to. Now, if you haven't got, squish that up, if you haven't got a proper rolling pin, or you can't get hold of a wooden one in a hurry, these ones here, this is just a cardboard one from one of those really big fabric rolls. Now, I don't know if you can, I think you can probably go to one of the fabric shops and ask them for their spare rolls, because of course when they run out of the fabric, they've got a whole lot of these to get rid of, these cardboard things, and they're really thick, like the cardboard's quite thick, and they're really, really strong. So they will roll out your clay quite easily. And this one, fortunately, you can just see the sort of the lines on there, the typical spiral that you see on a cardboard roll. But these are very fine lines, so they're not even showing up in the clay. See, that's just rolling out really nicely. And then once you've got your slab rolled out, then you can use one of these ribs. These silicon ribs I really like because they're quite flexible, but they're still firm enough to compress your clay. So just when you roll a slab, always just go over a little bit, just to smooth off any lines, and also just helps compress it as well, which can, I'm told, prevent cracking. In fact, look, I do that all the time, and so far so good. I've had minimal cracks. excuse me, minimal cracks. So it hasn't been a problem. But it's something I learned many years ago, and it's something I've just kept doing to this day, and it works. Get yourself one of these silicon ribs or kidney tools. You can get them at the clay suppliers, but you could even use those plastic ones that you get with cooking, those plastic ones you use to lift your chopped veggies up off the chopping board. They're really cool too. They work just as well, as long as you've got something that you can glide across your surface and put a little bit of pressure on your clay. Have fun.